couldn't think of a clever intro for this ranking because these movies are all about slapstick comedy, and I already did that with my Loki reaction. My back hurts. Where's the ice? Welcome back to another video, everybody. My name is Gabriel, and I love to rank movies. If you can relate, you're definitely going to want to hit that subscribe button and know that this list is just my opinion, but I would love to see yours down in the comment section. But with that said, let's get started. Last place is easily going to go to Home Alone 4, Taking Back the House. It's funny how the same franchise can have some movies that are 10 out of 10, and then one that's an easy 0 out of 10, which is this film. I'd rather get coal from Santa than this movie. It's about how the McAllister dad leaves his wife for a younger and richer lady, and Kevin has to choose who to spend Christmas with, the robbers come, and yada yada. Everyone looks depressed in this film, and there was no scene that I enjoyed. All the acting was terrible, especially on the robbers part, because I think French Stewart is a horrible actor, and the person that plays Marv's wife is even worse. Almost everyone's favorite part about the Home Alone movies is the traps, but this film only has a few, and when there are traps, they aren't even good. And then you come to the twist, which the studio ripped straight out of every single Scooby-Doo episode. They're trying to make you think it's this one person, and it's obviously not, and then the characters act so surprised when they realize it's this other person they always thought was nice. And I saw the twist coming from a mile away, and this is just a terrible film in every way. Next up in fourth place is Home Alone 5, The Holiday Heist. Comparing this film to the fourth, it takes a step in the right direction, but not a big one. This film has a bunch of idiotic, unfunny characters and performances, but I did laugh when Simon called the police, and he worded what he was saying so badly the SWAT team broke into his house, even though that is a complete copy-off of Christmas Vacation. The traps are ill-conceived and are pure luck, but the robbers could easily avoid them, so the traps are just stupid. If you're a huge fan of the original Home Alone movies, I think you can skip this film. It's not really worth your time, but it is pretty enjoyable, even though it's low budget, and you can tell pretty easily it's a made-for-TV film. Kicking off the top three is Home Alone 3. You don't watch this film and think Home Alone. The McAllisters are gone, which I actually think was the right choice because I don't think the same kid would get robbed three times. The new kid that has to set up the traps in this film isn't bad at all. I think he gave a solid performance, but Macaulay Culkin was better, and I think he's one of the greatest child actors of all time, while he's been in some classic films like Uncle Buck, My Girl, and obviously Home Alone. This movie is still produced by John Hughes, but it got a completely different cast and director. They definitely tried to make more of a campy style and just goofy fun, but it doesn't live up to the first two films. There were some funny scenes and traps, but it's not even close to being as good as the first two films, even though it's just good enough for me to watch a couple times without getting tired of it. My runner-up is actually going to the original Home Alone. This film 100% deserves the credit it gets every holiday season. Everyone always loves the third act of the film, but that's not all that's great about it. The plot is absolutely perfect, and John Williams' score is unforgettable, with songs that I'm always humming after I watch this film. But obviously, the icing on the cake is the cast. Macaulay Culkin as Kevin has a great performance, and Joe Pesci, the serious actor that starred in Goodfellas the same year as Home Alone, is actually great as a comedic actor. There's even a cameo by John Candy. Daniel Stern is hilarious, and this is actually the movie I have rewatched the most. My grandma owned this film on DVD, so every time I went to her house, I would watch it, and adding all of those times up, plus when I watched this film during the holiday season, I've seen this film too many times to count. And it is an amazing film to this day. When Nolan from Nolan Talks Movies reviewed this film, in the intro he said that Home Alone has some very metaphorical messages about the importance of family, but then he's kidding and he says the film is pure fun. While the film is pure fun, I think it does tell us about the importance of family. Kevin says he didn't want his family, and then to his surprise, he wakes up the next morning and his family is gone. He thinks it's fine, but while the film goes along, he realizes he misses them and he wants them back, and then when his mom finds him at the end. It's just a very touching moment. Also, if you haven't subscribed to Nolan's channel, you're definitely going to want to, because he has lots of amazing movie content just like me, and you can find his channel up in the iCard in the right-hand corner. And if you didn't know, a couple weeks back, Netflix released the show The Holiday Movies That Made Us. That show is based on the older Netflix show that was made in 2019, The Movies That Made Us. There was an episode about the behind the scenes of Home Alone that I thought was really interesting and great. If you like the Home Alone movies, I think that episode is worth a watch. But back to the movie. The traps are great and all, but the entire film is amazing. I laughed from start to finish, and when it comes to the quotable lines and over-the-top performances, too. So overall, this is a great film, but for first place, I'm gonna give it to Home Alone 2. This film is simply incredible. I've heard lots of people say this film is worse than the original, but the people that say it's better normally say that for the climax and having bigger and better traps. But I think this film is better for that reason and the middle of the movie. I'm not saying it's the most original film ever made, because it completely copies the first film, just takes the structure and makes it take place in a different place. I know I'm saying what a lot of people say about this film, but somehow this film just captures the magic of the first film so well, I think it's even better. It's got side characters played by Roy Schneider, Tim Curry, and even a cameo by Donald Trump.
Excuse me, where's the lobby?
Down the hall and to the left.
Thanks.
What, is Joe Biden gonna be in the upcoming Home Alone reboot starring Archie Yates from Jojo Rabbit? I think this film is even funnier than the original, and even more touching moments with the bird lady. I understand why some people think this is a complete rehash of the first film, and it is not good at all, but I think it's absolutely amazing, even though it relies on coincidences to keep the plot going. This is easily one of my favorite Christmas movies. In fact, it's my second favorite one, the first being... Actually, I'll have you wait to figure that out until I release my top 20 Christmas films of all time, coming sometime a little bit closer to Christmas. Hi guys, thanks so much for watching. If you're new to the channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and click the bell icon to be notified when I upload a new video. But with that said, Merry Christmas and stay tuned and subscribe to Cinema Franks.